It's 10 p.m. Do you know where you can get falafel right now? To answer this question, you'd need a place search that filters results based on whether they are open now. This video explains how to implement a filtered search through HTTP requests to the Web Services API and the Places library in the Maps JavaScript API. Here's a chart summarizing what you can expect from each endpoint. First, I'll talk about the Web Services API. If you are doing a nearby search or text search and want to only receive places back that are currently open, include the parameter openNow in your request to either the nearby search or text search endpoint. Just including the parameter name in the request is enough. You don't have to specify a value. Whichever one of the place search endpoints you use, you will see a field opening underscore hours in each of the place results if we have information about the opening hours for that place and the places marked operational, meaning not marked temporarily or permanently closed. You'll receive back a response with an array of results whose opening hours overlap with the time that the request was made. You can verify this by looking for the opening hours field. In place search responses, opening hours has just one subproperty called open underscore now with a value true if the current time falls within the establishment's listed opening hours and a value false if the current time is outside the listed opening hours. If you want to display both open and closed results, omit the open now parameter and look for the open underscore now property of opening underscore hours for each result to see whether that place is currently open or not. Find place works a bit differently since you're searching for a specific place rather than doing a general search. Find place doesn't support the open now parameter, but does allow you to specify which fields you want returned in the response. This is where you would specify that you want to see the field opening underscore hours in the response. Just like with the other place search endpoints, look for the opening hours field of each result returned in the results array, and check the subproperty open underscore now to see if the current time falls within the establishment's listed opening hours. Now let's talk about how to filter for open places in JavaScript. Just a reminder, we have a Node.js client library for server-side implementations that is based on the Web Services API, so if you want the behavior I described in the earlier part of this video but using JavaScript, consider using that library instead. For client-side implementations, the Places library in the Maps JavaScript API has deprecated the open underscore now property of the opening hours field in favor of the isOpen method that can be used with placeDetails results. For nearby search and text search in the Places library of the Maps JavaScript API, you can specify that you only want search results returned that are currently open by using the request parameter openNow. In the JavaScript API, setting openNow to true in your request means that you only want results that are operational and currently open. Setting openNow to false has no effect, so you'll get back both open and closed places just as if you hadn't included the openNow parameter at all. Note that in the JavaScript API, findPlace doesn't support a filter for places that are open now, and the opening hours field is also not returned. Instead, make a free ID-only findPlace call and select the place you want to check from the returned results, and use that place ID in a placeDetails request specifying the opening underscore hours field to check if it is currently open. If you feel like that's all a bit tricky to get straight, remember you can always check the documentation linked in the video description below for the most up-to-date information about how each of the endpoints and SDKs behaves with the Places API. You might be interested in two related videos, retrieving the full opening hours information from the placeDetails endpoint and checking for operational status, such as temporary closures using the business status field. Thanks for watching and happy coding!